Hi, I'm Mr. Flores, and I support students with learning difficulties in grade 2 through 5. I have several students who are not meeting grade level expectations. I've tried a lot of different things, but they continue to fall further behind. Where do I start?
Hi, I'm Sarah Powell, and I'm an associate professor at the University of Texas at Austin. And I'm here to be your guide through this mathematics course. In this course, we're going to think about how to provide really good mathematics instruction to students that have learning difficulties. So if you're a teacher like Mr. Flores, this course is just for you. Now, in this course, we're going to talk about data-based individualization, and we're going to use this framework to help guide this entire course. You may have seen this framework before, or it might be brand new to you, but let me talk briefly about this framework. Within this framework for data-based individualization, or DBI, we start with a validated intervention platform. And we're going to talk a lot about that in this course. But you can never do instruction without monitoring the progress of students who are receiving that instruction. So that's where this progress monitoring component comes into play. Now, when students are doing well with the instruction, then we're going to continue doing that really good instruction. But when students are not responding as we would like them to do, then we are going to do a diagnostic, and we'll adapt the intervention based on the information from that diagnostic. And then, as always, we will continue to progress monitor to determine whether students are responsive or not responsive to those intervention adaptations. So that's what we're going to talk about in this course. So let me show you what we're going to do in each part of the course. So in the first module, let me go ahead and get it started up here, we're going to think about developing a scope and sequence for intervention. So that helps us start right here, because you can never start instruction without understanding where you're going with your instruction. In module 2, we're going to go and talk about progress monitoring and how to determine whether students are responding or not responding to the instruction. And that's green because it deals with one of the assessment components of this DBI framework. In the third module, we will think about how do you select an evidence-based practice to start your instructional platform. And then in module 4, we'll think about the delivery of that instruction. So once you've chosen an evidence-based program or an evidence-based strategy, how do you implement it? And we will focus a lot on explicit instruction, using multiple representations, and making sure we have adequate math language. In the fifth module, we're going to focus on instructional strategies that should be embedded within our instructional platform. And we'll focus specifically on fluency building and problem solving. And then in module 6, we'll talk about whole number content. In module 7, it'll be rational number content. And then finally in module 8, we'll talk about how do we make adaptations to the instructional program when necessary. And also, how do we measure fidelity to make sure that we're doing the program as it's meant to be done? Now I'm going to turn you over to another Sarah. So our objectives for this module are the following. First thing we're going to do is in part one, we're going to talk about why is mathematics intensive intervention important? Why do we need to do this for students? In part two, we're going to look at the mathematical content that students need to master across grades. And in this course, we're focusing on kindergarten through eighth grade, although you could use a lot of this information before kindergarten and also into high school. And then in part three of this module, we're going to think about how do we identify the math content and how do we sequence that within intensive intervention. So some of the activities that you're going to do here in part one, you're going to look at NAEP data for students with disabilities and compare the performance of students with disabilities to students without disabilities. You're also going to do a journal activity where you provide a rationale for why do we need to do intensive intervention. You might need to convince some people in your school that this is a good thing, and this will get you started thinking about that. In part two, you're going to do quite a few different workbook activities. You're going to place operations content in order. So that is content from kindergarten through seventh or eighth grade, thinking about how students understand the operations. Can you place it in order? That's going to have implications for how we design our intensive intervention. You're going to do that with the operations. You're going to do that with the problem-solving content. And then you'll also do another workbook activity right here where you'll look at foundational skills that are necessary to include an intensive intervention for a student. And you'll engage in a discussion board where you'll talk with your other classmates about things that you have coming up soon that you might be teaching and the foundational skills you might want to include in that teaching. And then finally, when we get to part three, you'll do workbook activities about figuring out different foundational skills for students, looking at student strengths and weaknesses, and planning for intensive intervention. And then you'll do a journal activity here where you'll think about one of your current students and you'll reflect upon the intensive intervention that you're going to provide for that student. Now in module one, we do have a reading. Our reading is listed here. I'm going to talk just a little bit about this reading. So this reading was written by me and a colleague, Pam Stecker, and it's really a good introduction to data-based individualization. So I hope that you will read it. I'd like you to read it actually before part one. I think that would be a good time to read this article. So in this article, you're introduced to a student named Molly. We see what types of progress monitoring measures her teacher is using with her. And then it goes through this whole DBI process. So what we can see here is that Molly is participating in intensive intervention, but her scores aren't exactly where we would like them to be. And so the teacher makes an instructional adaptation. So that's very, very important within DBI. So we see that adaptation marked here with this dark line on the graph. And then the teacher does some new stuff with Molly, sees that it's not working as well as it could be. So we're through this process, we're progress monitoring, we're making decisions quickly. And then after another iteration, so we made another instructional adaptation, we see that Molly's scores start to increase. So it's a really nice intro article to this whole structure of DBI, and it's focused on mathematics. So it looks at DBI through a mathematics lens. Now, at the end of this module, you're going to have a classroom application. And that application is going to ask you to identify and map out the foundational mathematics skills that you might use in intensive intervention. So I know some of you work with first and second grade students. Some of you might work with middle school students. And so you're going to use your grade level or your grade levels, and you're going to think about what are the foundational mathematics skills that my students need to know at this grade level, and you're going to sequence those out. And that sequence will help you develop your intensive intervention later. So I'm really excited that you're here with us in this course, and especially in module one. So let's go ahead and get started.